start getting things moving around here and cleaned up and get all these people back to work.
It's a 160-foot tall beacon of hope over the Matanzas Pass Bridge. This massive crane lifted the first boat in the shrimping fleet back into the water today on Fort Myers Beach. Hurricane Ian tossed boats onto the land, onto docks, even into trees along San Carlos Island. You're watching NBC2, and I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. This has been one of the most dramatic images of the hurricane's destruction. Well, now the crane is bringing a glimmer of hope.
NBC2's Jennifer Vaglis is local on Fort Myers Beach tonight, showing us the massive project underway.
A lifeline standing 160 feet tall on Shrimp Boat Lane.
We're going to be back up and going real soon.
Bringing hope to some shrimpers on Fort Myers Beach. Ian rattled captains like Roger Schmall with four decades of experience.
I've seen the worst of the worst, and this one was just it. It was.
His boat, named after his grandchildren he raised himself, Caden Nicole. Schmall found it on land, split down the middle, lodged up to a tree.
It's still a shock. I come down and look at the boat every day, just shake my head. Oh, I miss it, but I'm done.
Today, he and dozens of other people watched from Erickson and Jensen Marine Supplies as work began to unravel this mess. Using a crane so big, it had to be hauled in pieces. Henry and Tracy Gore seeing the first boat, Double E, rise from its side, drain, and float again.
They're going boat by boat. Everything can change in a second. So they're the expertise in this.
Feeling positive about Lexi Joe, named after their two kids.
As far as we can tell, there's not a whole lot of damage to the hull, so we just gotta wait and see.
They have faith. Neighbors will bounce back too.
Our shrimping industry, we're a family, and we're coming together.
I'm local tonight on Fort Myers Beach, Jennifer Vaglis, NBC2.